Hi, Mark here from Lydian Stream. Today's video is all about recording. I want to give you tips from the point of view both of the producer and the point of view as a session musician, because for many years I've worked in both these fields. So here we go. From the point of view of the producer, three simple things. One, send the guy, girl, whoever's recording, a copy of the song you're working on with some kind of guide track showing them what you want. That's very important. That means they come to the studio knowing what you want, they've brought the right equipment, and they feel secure about what they're about to do. That all transfers itself to tape, and that's very important. So that's tip number one. Send them as much information as you can at the beginning without overwhelming them. Keep it loose. Point number two is making sure you get down on tape, on the computer, however you want to call it, what you envisioned and decided upon in your mind ahead of time. Maybe you decided with the client, you're your own client, it doesn't matter, but it's very important to stay true to your original ideas. They're your creative ideas and you need to get them down and trust them. How do you do that? When the session musician's in the studio, you get them to do a bunch of takes until you know you've covered all the different stuff in the song that you want from them, that you have good recordings that you can edit together. Once you've got that nailed, then the fun really starts, and this is point three, and here I've really done and had the fortune, good fortune, to really get some amazing takes from musicians. Because then I turn around to that same musician and say, okay, now you go in there and you do what you want to do. Anything you want. You know, I just want your energy, I want your vibrancy, I want what's special about you, I want the reason we brought you into the studio. And then what's really great is that 99% of the time, they will play a track very similar to the original ideas they've been working on for the last few hours, but they'll do it from a different place emotionally. They'll do it with security, because they know you already have a take that you're happy with. They'll do it with passion, because they're feeling open. They'll do it with improvisation. And most importantly, they will give you their own voice. Because the biggest tip you can learn about recording is that emotional behavior, the way we feel, transfers itself to tape, to the recording machine, and we can feel that vibe. And that's why sometimes you hear a really lousy recording, but it's more passionate than the most special recording, because you're feeding into the emotions of the musician who laid down that track. Now let's look at it from the point of view of a session musician. Really, it's like the producer ideas, but in reverse. You as a musician, push the producer, the client, to send you a copy of what it is you're going to be working on so you can be prepared. It will give you security, you'll know what equipment to take. If the producer turns around to me and says, listen, I don't have any ideas, I want you to do what you want, don't go for that. That can lead to a black hole, especially down the road when you're getting, if you're getting paid, even if you're not getting paid. You should get paid. I just want to make that point absolutely clear here. You're getting paid, you go into the studio, you lay down what you like because that's what they ask you to do. 2 weeks later, the chances are they're going to call you and say, listen, we're not happy with what you did. Can you come and do it again? And they're not going to pay you any more money. So to avoid that, you want to make sure that the producer slash client guides you and tells you what they want. Once they've done that and you've followed their plan, so to speak, what they need, they can't ever come back to you and say, hey, we didn't get what we needed. Once they said the session's over, they're happy, that's it. The session is over and they're happy. What I do suggest is that after that, if there's time, say to them, listen, I'd really love to lay down a track with my own kind of spontaneous feel, feeding off of the ideas that you had. Maybe it's stuff you can use in the track. That way you'll be putting your own voice in there. You'll be showing that you're confident. You'll be giving them something original and unique, and they will remember that you gave from yourself and your creative spirit within the definition, within the context of the piece of music that they asked you to come and play on. So to summarize, obviously, every producer works differently and they have different ways of approaching and working with session musicians. What I've found out is that when I'm clear about my own guidelines and I stick to them, this gives me a sense of security and I can go in and do the job at a very high standard. So again, know what works for you and that will be respected and taken on board and will resonate throughout the industry as you move forward through the years as a professional musician. Hope this helps. Wishing you the best of stuff. and let the music lead.